Welcome to the fourth part of the analog console journey. Today I would like to share some of the pros and the cons that come with owning an analog console, especially one like this, which is both old and cheap. So let's get started with the good things first. The first thing that I have really enjoyed during my limited time with this console has been the workflow when recording. When you get the hang of how everything works on it, it's much easier and faster to set up a recording session on the console, because you have everything in front of you. One of the things that I absolutely love is the fact that you can set up to 6 headphone mixes using the auxes straight from the board, which means that you can make everyone happy with what they are listening to in their headphones, and also all these mixes are zero latency because they come before the analog to digital conversion. To continue on the subject of workflow, the best thing for me about owning this console is the tactile response. The fact that while recording, I barely have to touch the keyboard or the mouse helps me get into a completely different mindset and pushes me to focus less on the screen and more on the sound. This, when paired with the limited visual feedback that you get from the board, has forced me to trust my ears more and has also made me lean more towards the saying, if it sounds good, it is good. All in all, it is a much more rewarding and fun experience recording with the console, because if you commit to it, you have much more precise options and this makes the session run smoother. Now, the sound is something that can be viewed as good or bad depending on what you want. When having a board and using its preamps, you have the same sonic signature on everything you record. This can be good if you want to try the, I guess, old school method of everything going through the same piece of gear, but if you want different voices or characters, I think you are much better off with individual preamps. That being said, for me, the fact that I got 24 channels of preamps alongside the EQ is a no-brainer. I love the fact that they have their own character, and while they are not by any means high-end, I really like the results that I get when everything is recorded through the console. And who knows, maybe in the future I will add a couple of outboard preamps just to have different options. Now for the cons. And the biggest one for me is time. First of all, the time it takes to learn how to properly use this thing, especially if you are coming from in the box like I guess most of us are. It takes some time to learn how to properly gain stage, as well as what you can and can't do with EQ. And these are things that of course you can experiment with on paying sessions, so you have to devote the time to sit and learn all those stuff so that you're ready for your first recordings. When I decide to mix through the console, I have to factor in the time that it takes to bounce each individual track, especially because my setup is not optimized for this kind of workflow, so I have to bounce each track individually and then continue working on them with plugins. Finally, and I guess this is true for most analog gear, is the matter of maintenance. If you have something that is not properly maintained, it will have issues like noises and stuff that you definitely don't want in a recording. For example, right now, this console, although it has a brand new power supply, and I have done a full recap of it, has a high frequency noise, which gets much more profound if you decide to push the high frequencies with the equalizer. It also has the same high frequency noise on the headphone mixings, which can be really annoying, especially when you are recording softer music. So although we are carefully using it right now, we are at the same time trying to find the source of the problem so that we can remove all those unwanted noises. Another thing that I definitely didn't enjoy was the cables and wiring everything up. I spent on cables almost as much as I have spent on the console, and the wiring, while it's really nice when everything is set up and you can play with the patch bays and try stuff out really fast, the process is something that I really am not looking forward to doing again anytime soon. So you may think that with all these negatives, this isn't for you, but if you ever wonder how it is to work on an analog console, something like this, which is a Soundtracs M24, is a really nice way to try it out, because you can get your feet wet in this kind of thing without spending a fortune. Now, is this for everyone? Absolutely not. But if you are anything like me, give it a try. You may find something that you really like. If you enjoyed this video, you can check out the other videos I have made about this console documenting the journey from the start. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Talam, and I'll see you in the next one.